as we get older, the cosmetic benefits of exercising sometimes become secondary to the things that you might have once taken for granted. And with us this morning to do some great balance drills is our 2 News fitness expert, Wes Cole. Balance drills. Now, that's something that sounds easy, but it's not.
Well, just like you said, as people get older, big arms and ripped abs, they become less of a priority.
Yeah.
More things like, balance, being able to walk around without hurting yourself becomes an issue. So we got some great drills today,
sure.
And Beth is going to demonstrate. The very first one is what I like to call a squat and reach. And what Beth is doing is she's basically using an inanimate object. You can use a coffee cup. You can something like a little bit higher off the ground. As you can see, she's bending her knee and she's twisting to the side. Where most people fall is when they move laterally to the side. And this exercise I do for a lot of my senior citizens, and it might be hard at first. You can maybe practice holding onto a wall. This right here will really help. And then another variation is go ahead and do the single leg one, just kind of straight on, a little bit easier. And she's just keeping her legs straight, and she's also working on the posterior part of her legs, her hamstrings. This is a good way to stretch out. Like I said, lack of mobility and lack of flexibility go hand in hand. So this right here, maybe 3 or 4 sets of 10 to 12 reps. You can see her legs shaking.
Yeah, it looks like it's a little, I mean, I don't think I'd even be able to do it in high heels.
when you work your balance, you're really working all the muscle fibers are firing a little bit differently, but it's really kind of one of those things that if you don't practice your balance, if you don't use it, you lose it. So practicing this right here is really, really good. It'll go a long way to really help you out. So the next one, of course, is a lateral step up. And I don't know if this is maybe a little bit more advanced.
All right.
But you want to be in a little bit better shape. But you can get a box, you can get a real stable chair. You see a lot of people doing traditional step ups in the gym. But like I said, moving laterally, to the side right here will really make a difference. A lot of my senior citizens, they build up to where they can do this. And it really, really makes a big difference. A lot of people walk, a lot of people run, but as you can see, you're moving forward.
Yeah.
And doing exercises like this where you're twisting, you're kind of changing direction will really go a long way to helping your balance. And of course, just make sure you get both sides. Best just demonstrating one side right here, but it'll go a long way to helping you out. And of course, sports like tennis, something that requires some type of lateral motion. Running is great. I love that. But something that, kind of switches up the angles a little bit will definitely help. And of course, last but not least, people think balance, maybe it's a weak legs. Oftentimes, lack of balance has to do with a weak core.
Yes.
Because remember, all power starts in the center. Mm-hmm. Every strength coach will tell you that. One of my favorite exercises to do, one of the safest abdominal exercises, is just a good old-fashioned bridge.
Oh,
I don't really have to teach anyone how to do it. You just keep your, and as you can see right here, even though Beth is not flexing, there's no spinal flexion, her abs are really having to flex tight to stabilize her spine. This is something that you can do real easy. 3 or 4 sets, build up to 25 or 30 seconds, and you'll be good to go.
I do that one at home. It's tough. It seems
it
easy, but it is tough to do, actually.
Absolutely.
To hold it
she
for a long
is
time.
So strong, I can just stand
up
right on.
Beth is a pro. All right. She's getting out of here. All right, we have a couple viewer questions right now. First is, will your metabolism slow down if you don't eat enough food? From Philip.
Well, this is a huge, huge thing.
Yeah.
Several years ago, there was eating real frequently will speed up your metabolism. But a lot of current research has come out where this is just really not necessarily true.
Really?
And the thing about it is marketing is so effective these days that they can convince people that are eating too much that they're heavy because they're not eating enough. And it's really not true.
Yeah.
The thing about it is a lot of studies show that there's really no change in metabolism after 72 hours without food.
Really?
So, I wouldn't worry about that. If you skip lunch, your metabolism isn't going to slow down to a crawl. Your body's a lot smarter than that. And, then again, you don't want to skip meals to where you end up binging. But, if you miss a lunch or if you miss breakfast, your body's not going to shut down. It's
kind of one of those things I was always worried about. If you miss a meal, are you going to, is it going to affect you?
But studies show that, your body doesn't even really know it's skipping a meal till after a few days. So your body's a lot smarter than that.
Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
We appreciate you and Beth's time and all of those great examples of exercises. If you'd have a question you'd like Wes to answer, you can go to our Facebook page, KJRHTV, and post it on our wall. You can always call Wes at 749-0960 or visit his gym on 46th, just east of Sheridan.